first game ever at the New Georgia Dome. It's called a Mercedes Benz Stadium, but this is the first game of all time played. Today, we originally did not have any plans, but then how did I wake up out of bed on this?
We jumped up, like, sat up, like, super quick, and grabbed the computer.
And then I bought the tickets. So I woke up, I jumped out of the bed. I was like, oh, I forgot today's the first day of the game. After that, we're probably gonna walk around a little bit to kind of see other things. We're trying to get like a lot of action shots to show you all what they have offered here. So far, what we've seen is that they have a virtual reality machine that shows driving, like driving Mercedes Benz.
Gotta walk around some more, see what all is here. The seats are nice and cushioned. We have our own, like in the old stadium, we're gonna put our drinks right here in front. Now we're gonna put our drinks right here. Right.
And that was always weird because it's like, well, you had your drink right here. You have people leaning all back on your stuff, but now you don't have that issue. But this is really nice.
Did you show them where we're sitting?
Yes. Check out the view.
Yeah.
first pass ever in the new stadium, an interception.
Long story short, we didn't record in the car. We went out to Friday's, got us something to eat really quick. And then we watched the Conor McGregor and Floyd Mayweather fight. And then we called it a night. But overall, for our experience at the Mercedes Benz Falcons new stadium, the stadium is really nice. If you go to the stadium, it would be worth your while. There's a lot of things you do, from virtual reality machines to bar areas, from standing on the field, visitor or Falcon side. But if you want to get floor access, that is an additional fee. I guess since today it was a preseason game, they really didn't stress the fact that we were down there. So, but hey, why not try it out? If they stop you, what's the worst that's going to happen? But overall, it was really nice. You have to go. It's very much different than the Georgia Dome, as you can see through the video. Now, on the media, on the news, they've been saying the whole thing, a whole lot of stuff about Arthur Blank saying, you know, oh, you know, the food is real affordable. It's $2, $3 for food. That's true. As you saw, we got one box of pizza, one box of popcorn, the water. That was all for $7. The last dome, it probably would have been about $15, $18. But the truth and reality is that the tickets are like, for if you want to buy them off of things like StubHub or Ticketmaster, to go to a game, I think nosebleeds is going to cost you around $200, $300, maybe $150. And that's a lot of money. So, you know, don't sit there and try to flex about the fact that the, you know, price of food is cheap. But you're paying about, especially if it's like a date night, you're spending over $1,000 to get into the door. But besides that, hopefully prices do change, because I would like to go again. But overall, today was a good night. About to go ahead and call it a night. If you're new to this channel and this is your first time ever seeing one of our vlogs, please make sure that you subscribe to our channel. We appreciate you all for watching, and God bless. See y'all next time. Peace.